For today's top headlines, let's go over to the CBN News Desk.
Gordon, what's left of Tropical Storm Ida is still packing a punch as it moves up the East Coast. So far, the storm has killed at least 5 people and eroded beaches and flooded neighborhoods. Paul Strand has the story.
Ida's harsh winds are still pounding hard against Maryland, Delaware, and New Jersey after whipping up to more than 70 miles an hour in Virginia.
We're just getting double banged with winds and rains, and, you know, that could cause power outages, trees down.
It just shows you how powerful nature is, and it puts things in perspective.
It's eating into the dunes right now. There's a young lady walking up. I says, don't go too close to the edge because it looked like, you know, it could collapse at any time.
I don't know if the dune's going to hold up. I really don't. It's scary. Probably lose some stores.
Virginians bore much of the storm's most powerful punch, causing some areas around cities like Norfolk to be evacuated.
I heard something banging against the house, so I woke up, looked out my side mirror in my bedroom, and there was water flooded everywhere around my house. My house was surrounded with water, so it looked like a lake.
A falling tree nearly hit Paris Diaz and his grandmother.
The whole house was shaking. It was just shaking and stuff.
What we're experiencing is what appears to be a classic nor'easter, an exceptionally strong, exceptionally slow-moving nor'easter.
This situation will obviously be aggravated through Friday evening.
Paul Strand, CBN News.
Business cards found in the apartment of U.S. Army Major Nidal Hassan reveal more of his views on Islam. On the cards, Hassan declared himself a soldier of Allah. Printed beneath his name were the acronyms SOA and SWT. SOA stands for Soldier of Allah. It's commonly used on jihadist websites. SWT is used by Muslims to mean glory to God. One FBI agent tells ABC News, it's another piece of evidence investigators might have found if they had taken a hard look at Nidal Hassan. The controversial community organizing group ACORN is now suing the federal government. Congress voted to cut all federal funding from the group after a video scandal uncovered them committing tax fraud. That cost them millions in government funds. ACORN is suing to try to get that money back, claiming Congress violated the Constitution. ACORN officials say they underestimated the impact of the congressional action. Evangelist Billy Graham invited his family to his 95th birthday. Franklin Graham says his famous father gave that invitation at his 91st birthday celebration last weekend. The younger Graham says that that shows his father is still pretty optimistic. And he says his father watches the news, answers correspondence, and receives guests. Deadly mudslides killed more than 130 people in El Salvador this past weekend. More than 12,000 people were left homeless. CBN's Operation Blessing, along with medical teams from the Mayo Clinic, are in the region bringing help to survivors. The aid organization has been distributing food to local families, and the team of doctors is offering emergency care to victims over the next few days. Operation Blessing has had an ongoing relationship with the Mayo Clinic to bring medical training and free health care to communities across El Salvador. You can find out more by going to ob.org.